Okay, today we're going to talk about observation and inferences. These are two important skills that you'll need when conducting experiments. The ability to make observations on what you're experimenting on, and the ability to make an inference based on your observations. Okay, observations are things that you can note using your five senses, things you can see, touch, feel, smell, taste. Okay, they tend to be facts, things that you know as soon as you see. Okay, so for example, we're gonna look here at my Get to Know Miss Murray board. And you can see here, you can make a couple observations. One, the background of the board is blue. You see that, you see the blue cloth there and you know it's blue, okay? Another observation, there are pictures of Miss Murray from high school, so you can see those. There are pictures of Miss Murray in college, and you see those. Okay, those are all observations, things that you can absolutely see. Miss Murray went to Notre Dame. You can tell that from the pictures. Okay, now inferences are things that you can gather from your observations. They're not necessarily true. You don't know based on your, you don't know if they're true or not, but based off your observations, you can predict or guess whether or not they would be. For example, an inference here would be Miss Murray's favorite color is blue. She has a lot of blue up, she must like it. You don't know that for sure, but just based on all the blue, you can infer that, okay? There's pictures of me from high school softball. You can infer that I was a good softball player. You don't know that. You just see a picture. You know I played softball, but you don't know if I was good or if I wasn't. That's an inference, okay? Miss Murray loves to draw. Those sketches up there are mine. You know that they're mine because I've signed them and you've seen them, but you don't know if I love to draw or if I just, you know, draw because I can. There's a picture here. See if I can zoom in on it, of Miss Murray with Tigger. Okay, the inference would be Miss Murray's favorite Disney character is Tigger. You're not sure if that's my favorite character or not. You're just making that inference based on the observation that there is a picture of Miss Murray with Tigger. Okay? So again, an observation is a fact. It's something that you can see, hear, taste, smell, feel. Okay? You know it when you see it. Right? An inference is an estimation or a guess or a hypothesis that you make based off of what you observe, okay? It's not necessarily there. It's not necessarily going to be fact, but you can base it off what you observe, okay? Questions, feel free to ask. We'll be doing observation and inference for about a week or so. And doing it in a very interesting and fun way. I'm not going to spoil it for you here. So again, observations, using your five senses, okay, see, touch, hear, smell, taste. Inference is a hypothesis or an assumption based off of your observation. All right? Next, we'll talk about qualitative and quantitative observations. Welcome back. Now we're going to talk about qualitative and quantitative observations. Our observations can be broken down into either a qualitative or a quantitative observation. Okay? Qualitative deals with descriptors. You're going to describe what it looks like, what it feels like, what it tastes like, smells like, or sounds like. Okay? So for example, a qualitative observation here would be the background of Miss Murray's bulletin board is blue. That's qualitative. Okay? The dragon that she sketched over here is green and yellow. That's qualitative. You're describing what you see. Okay, so qualitative observations are descriptive. Okay, quantitative deals with numbers. If you think of the word quantitative, it builds off of the word quantity, and quantity talks about amounts, okay? Amounts of things. So quantitative is based off numbers. Now these numbers can be measurements. So you could measure something and say the border of Miss Murray's bulletin board is a meter long. And that would be quantitative because that measurement is a number. Okay? The clover on Miss Murray's bulletin board has 4 leaves. That's a quantitative observation. You're counting the number of leaves. There's 4 of them. Okay? So quantitative observation. There are 4 sketches on Miss Murray's bulletin board. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. The dancers, the tiger holding a fish, the dragon, and the unicorn. Okay? Again, quantitative, dealing with numbers, 4 sketches. Okay? So to review, qualitative, descriptive. You're going to describe what it looks like, what it feels like, sounds like, smells like, tastes like. Quantitative deals with numbers. Okay? It can be a measurement. It can be a time. Okay? It can be just counting how many things there are. I think there are 14 pictures on Miss Murray's board. Okay? That's quantitative. The letters on Miss Murray's bulletin board are all lowercase. That is a qualitative observation. You're describing what they look like. Okay? Any questions, feel free to ask. Feel free to review. We will be practicing identifying these kinds of observations and making them, as well as identifying and making inferences as well. So stay tuned, and thanks for watching.